Hi everyone, this is Rishakhi Chakraborty, journalist of Lafalafi, along with Ambarish Patra behind the lens. Today we have with us someone who is a big fashionista and also an actor, model, anchor, writer, and I don't know how many talents she has. Karuna Ezara Parikh with us. Karuna Ezara Parikh, the writer, the anchor, the actor, the model, and also a fashionista. So, given an option, which one will you choose?
If I had to choose one identity that I think defines me above the others, I would choose writer.
Okay, so Ezara writes, reveals the writer in you. Do you have a plan for a book or something?
Well, hopefully, that's what my dream is, to eventually publish a book, maybe of my poems, maybe a novel. I'm not sure right now which direction it's going to go in first. But yes, that's my goal, I guess, and that's what my dream is eventually.
Okay, so you are so gorgeous and talented.
Thank you.
So, do you want to step into the film industry or...?
So I have had offers from the film industry in the past. They were never roles that took my fancy. They were not anything that I identified with. So far, not at all. I think at this point in my life, it would take a magnificent role with a lot of impact and social impact, let's say, and a very dynamic sort of character for me to say yes. I'm much more interested in, for example, writing a script or a screenplay. I've co-written a screenplay in the past, and that is much more interesting for me right now as opposed to acting in a film.
Okay, so you have a very unique appearance. So according to you, what makes you unique?
I don't know. Ethnically, I'm a big mix of things. Most people think I'm Punjabi, but I'm not. I'm many different things. And I think that gives me a sort of, you know, unique appearance, as you so graciously put it. I also think that my tattoos play a big role. There's not many Indian women who have such elaborate tattoos as this. So I think that immediately makes me very striking and different from the others. So maybe I was not born looking different, but I made myself unique, you know. So yeah, I'd say that.
Okay, so you are very fond of body art. What inspired you to have so many tattoos?
Different things for different tattoos. I always felt that tattooed bodies were very beautiful. Since I was a child, I couldn't wait to get my first tattoo. You know, the second I turned 18, I went to get a tattoo, even though my parents were very unhappy about it at that time. And I continued to do so. I'm finally in a place where I'm very happy with the amount of tattoos I have. I don't think I want to get that many more now. But yeah, I was always very inspired by making your body your own, you know. It's sort of an act of reclaiming your own body and imprinting your own personality on it. So yeah, I guess that was why.
Okay, so you have, I mean, you know many types of sari draping and all. So are you self-taught completely?
My mom taught me to tie a sari when I was about, I think, 11 or 12 years old. And she can tie it with a blindfold on her, I think, and it looks perfect. And I guess just seeing the way she tied it so easily, you know, she always made it a very simple act. It was always a very simple act for her, you know. There was no stress of, oh, I have to wear a sari, so I need to take time to wear it. No, she just used to put it on like that and done, you know. So I guess she was my example, and it became very easy for me as well. And I'm happy because today I see so many young girls who just can't tie a sari. Most of my friends are not comfortable tying their own saris. And that makes me sad because it's almost a dying art then, right? So I don't have to do what many have to do, like look at a YouTube video or something. I'm very proud to say that I can tie it myself. I can do a variety of sari drapes on my own, and I love it. So I'm glad that I can. Makes it easier to wear.
And you travel a lot.
Yeah.
What leads you into traveling?
I started traveling as a child because I had family around the world. So, you know, I was lucky enough to be taken to visit different family members around the world. But what really sort of pushed me into travel was my travel shows on television. Once I signed up with NDTV and I started traveling for work, I think every month I was in new locations around the globe, and that really put a passion in me for traveling, because the more you see, the more you want to see. You know, you go to one place, then you hear about another place, then you hear, but you know, that beach is better, that mountain is amazing. And so I just started chasing that, you know, what's even better. And I think when you travel, you gain such a sense of the world in its entirety, of different cultures, different people, different cuisines, different languages. And it really opens up your mind, you know. You don't stay in that box or bubble that you've been brought up in or live in. So I think it's essential to open oneself up to the world.
Okay, so any message for your fans?
Message for my fans? That's a big thing you ask. Well, I know that the people who follow me and who follow my work, and the people I've been so lucky to be exposed to, are people who are looking for something that I too have strived for in my life. They're looking for something authentic. They're looking for something unique. They're looking for something genuine in a world that I think is very rapidly changing, and a world that is very rapidly becoming more and more plastic and fake in some ways. So even though my fans probably know me through an Instagram, through a photo shoot, through a television, I would love for them to know that the most important thing is authenticity, and is about being honest, not just to yourself, but to your craft, to those around you, and to your own audiences. We each have an audience, you know, it's not just me with a big Instagram following. No, even in your day-to-day life, you have an audience. So it's about being as authentic with that audience as possible. And I think that is also a key to happiness in a world that is becoming quite fake over time.
Okay, so any message for Lafa Lafi?
I guess the same thing, you know, along the same lines. I think we share a very similar ideology. So yeah, the same.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.